In Fire Emblem Three Houses, Sothis is the progenitor goddess of Fodlan, who helps your protagonist throughout the story and grants you the ability to turn back time whenever you make a mistake on the battlefield. And her name is pretty significant. You see, the name Sothis comes from the ancient Greek pronunciation of the name Sobtet, an ancient Egyptian goddess who was a personification of the brightest star in our night sky, Sirius, aka the Dog Star, so called on account of it being part of the constellation Canis Major, the Greater Dog. In ancient Egypt, Sothis, or Sobtet, was known as the bringer of the new year on account of the star's heliacal rising, meaning its annual appearance in the dawn sky just before the yearly flooding of the Nile, which marked the beginning of the Egyptian civil calendar. Now, due to the progression of the equinoxes, today the star's heliacal rising occurs in August, but every 1,460 years, it aligns with the summer solstice, during the season known to the ancient Egyptians as Akhet, meaning inundation, a reference to the Nile floods. Because of this, Sothis, or Sobtet, was considered a particularly auspicious star. And since the star's rising occurred just as the Nile brought new life to Egypt, the goddess Sobtet was associated with fertility and prosperity. But what's interesting is that she was also associated with death and rebirth. The ancient Egyptians believed that since the dog star mysteriously disappeared every spring and then miraculously reappeared in the dawn sky 70 days later, that Sobtet must have been a sort of celestial guide for the deceased, one who prepared pharaohs for the afterlife by helping them navigate the underworld. Then, once the pharaohs were ready, she led the way to the heavens, where their souls became stars. This 70-day transition between death and rebirth was so symbolically important to the ancient Egyptians, they even synchronized the mummification process so that it took 70 days, the exact amount of time that the star Sirius, or Sothis, or Sobtet, remains hidden below the horizon. Stars were very important to the ancient Egyptians. Their pyramids and temples were aligned with the movement of the stars. And archaeologists have found coffins with star clocks drawn on the inside lid in order to help the deceased either find their way to the stars or instruct them on how to behave as a star. And in the ancient Egyptian astronomical text known as the Book of Nut, or more accurately as the Fundamentals of the Course of the Stars, Sothis's reliable movements were used as a model for the behavior of other star clusters, known as deacons. In short, Sobtet was very important in the life and afterlife of ancient Egyptians. Now, you may doubt that the Fire Emblem version of Sothis has much to do with an ancient Egyptian deity. After all, Sothis looks and acts more like Tiki from previous Fire Emblem games than a celestial fertility goddess associated with rebirth. But there's actually a lot of in-game evidence that the character is indeed based on her Egyptian counterpart. For a start, in the game, Sothis refers to herself as the Beginning. This is a reference to her status as a progenitor goddess, i.e. the mother of the Nabataeans. Life begins with her. And life in ancient Egypt began with the rising of the star Sothis, just before the flooding of the life-giving Nile. So there's one similarity. But there's actually a more direct astronomical correlation. According to Fire Emblem lore, there's a bright, shiny star that rises and sets every year in Fodlan. That star's name is the Blue Sea Star, a heavenly body associated with the goddess Sothis that sets in the month of the ethereal moon and rises in the month of the Blue Sea Moon. When the star reappears in the sky, the people of Fodlan celebrate its return with a ritual known as the Goddess's Rite of Rebirth. This fictional ritual reflects a very real Egyptian festival known as the Coming of Sobtet, which celebrated Sobtet's reappearance in the dawn sky and involved feasting and community gatherings. Another interesting fact, the real-life star, which has a bluish-white appearance, was sometimes known by the Egyptians as the Fair Star of the Waters, giving credence to the name Blue Sea Star in Fire Emblem. Now, not everyone has or had such positive feelings toward Sothis. In Fire Emblem, one of Sothis's nicknames is Felstar. It's never really clear why Sothis is called Felstar by her enemies, but the developers are most likely referring to the fact that some ancient cultures believe Sothis to be unlucky or destructive on account of it appearing during the hottest, driest, or muggiest days of the year. For example, in ancient China, Sothis, called the Celestial Wolf, denoted plunder and invasion. In ancient Greece, The star's scorching luminosity was thought to drive people mad, and anyone affected by its power was thought to be astroboletos, literally starstruck. The ancient Romans were so afraid of its power that they made sacrifices during the star's heliacal setting in spring in the hopes of avoiding a bad harvest when the star reappeared in summer. So by this logic, the game's villains calling Sothis Falstar actually makes sense. But the biggest similarity between the character Sothis and the Egyptian goddess is that both are closely associated with death and rebirth. In the game, Sothis is killed in her sleep by an Agarthan named Nemesis, and her immortal heart and bones are fashioned into a powerful weapon. Later, this weapon is recovered by the Nabataeans, and Sothis' heart is placed into the body of a mortal, allowing Sothis to be reborn, or at least for her conscience to be reawakened. This story of death, dismemberment, and rebirth closely resembles the story of the ancient Egyptian god Osiris, whose wife Isis was often associated with, or even conflated with, Soptet. By the way, Isis means throne, as in the throne of the pharaohs. And it's interesting to note that in Fire Emblem, Sothis is often depicted sitting on a throne. At any rate, Osiris was said to be Egypt's first pharaoh, and was responsible for introducing civilization and agriculture to mankind. According to Egyptian belief, after Osiris was killed by his jealous brother Set, the latter dismembered his body and scattered it around in the hopes it would never be found. Eventually, the pieces were located by Osiris' wife, Isis, who put him back together and revived him just long enough to conceive their son, Horus. After that, Osiris made his way to the afterlife and became god of the underworld, while part of his soul was immortalized in the heavens as the constellation Orion, or rather, possibly as one of the brightest stars in Orion, Rigel. And if you compare Osiris' story to the story of Sothis from Fire Emblem, there seems to be a pretty clear connection there. But that's not all. I mentioned earlier that the key to the character Sothis' rebirth is her heart. Is there any historical or cultural significance to that? Yes. You see, in ancient Egypt, the heart was thought to be the source of human wisdom, emotion, memory, the soul, and even someone's personality. In fact, to the ancient Egyptians, life started when a person's heart was formed by a drop of blood taken from the mother's heart at conception. Simply put, it represented a person's very existence. Therefore, the heart was the only organ not removed during mummification, so that the deceased could take it with them to the Hall of Judgment. There, the god of the underworld Osiris, along with 42 judges, including the goddess of universal harmony and balance Maat, would watch as the deceased's heart was placed on a scale that would reveal whether the person had led a good life or a bad life. If the heart was as light as the feather of Maat placed on the other side of the scale, it meant the person had led a good life, and the judges would allow them to enter the Field of Reeds, an eternal paradise. If the heart was heavy, then the person had lived a bad life, and their heart was eaten by the personification of divine retribution, the goddess Amit, at which point the person ceased to exist. The Egyptians were terrified of this fate and worried their heart would tattle on them during judgment. So when people were buried, they often had a stone amulet known as a heart scarab placed on their mummy with a spell written on it, asking the heart not to speak against them during judgment. In short, the heart was an essential part of one's rebirth, and it's no surprise that in Fire Emblem Three Houses, the heart of Sothis is key to her rebirth. And finally, there are a couple of aesthetic qualities that link the character Sothis to her Egyptian counterpart. If you look at the costume designs for characters associated with Sothis in Fire Emblem, you'll notice they all have star-like patterns somewhere on their clothes or accessories, including Sothis herself. And historically, the Egyptians almost always depicted Sothis as a human figure with a five-pointed star over her head. There's also a connection regarding Sothis' hair color. In Fire Emblem, Sothis has green hair because, well, she's basically just Tiki from previous Fire Emblem games. But her hair color wouldn't be out of place in ancient Egypt. Thousands of years ago, Egyptian nobility loved wearing hair extensions and wigs, and it was not unheard of to dye their wigs red, green, or even blue. In fact, one of the most famous ancient Egyptian queens, Nefertiti, was known to don blue-colored wigs. So, there you go. In conclusion, it's pretty clear and cool that the Fire Emblem Sothis is indeed tied to the ancient Egyptian goddess Soptet.